Hello students, in today's video I am going to discuss biomolecules part 3 mutarotation and inverted cane sugar. Sugar we call it as inverted cane sugar, why? And what is mutarotation? These two are bit confusing topics. I have given some note points also. Please, once we'll go through the topic, definitely we'll get idea. Please make a note, all the people along with me, you also take pen and paper, make a note. Mutarotation. There was a change in the specific rotation of sugar in aqueous solution with time is called mutarotation. There was a change in the specific rotation of sugar in aqueous solution with time is called mutarotation. What is this? How to discuss? What is the simple way we have to remember? See students, in previous videos, I have discussed glucose. Glucose pyranose structures I have discussed, and glucose open chain to cyclic structures, alpha form, beta form we have taken. So mutarotation is nothing but glucose. Glucose open chain form, open chain structure converting into alpha form. If you have any queries, any doubt, please go through the part 2, part 1 and come back to this video. Here open chain converting into alpha form, beta form. How, when we call it as alpha form, when we call it as beta form, clearly had explained in the previous videos. Open chain form of glucose converting into alpha form, converting into beta form, okay. So one second. Yes, converting into alpha form and again converting into beta form. Suppose you have taken your alpha form. Alpha form interconvertible to beta form. So how much alpha form here? 36% and beta form how much? 64%. First note down points, then we will discuss 119 degrees. This is plus 19 degrees. Here suppose the scientist or else you or else somebody made alpha form, in the laboratory. What is alpha form? Cyclic structure of glucose, right? Open chain structure we have, closed chain structures. This is alpha form, cyclic structure, right? Even beta form also cyclic structure. These two are interconvertible, See, suppose somebody made, you made alpha form. Alpha form, how much percent? It shows the rotation 110 degrees to 111 degrees. 110 degrees or 111 degrees, it is showing rotation. Okay, that you made, and kept in the laboratory. After some time, you have observed, or after one day you have observed, it is showing, so alpha form finally it is showing 52.5 degrees. You made alpha form, we all know alpha form, what is this, 110 degrees, 111 degrees. So, but why it is converting into plus 52.5? What is the reason? Maybe beta form also, beta form you made, but it is converting into after some time, after one day, plus 52.5. What is the reason? See here, whatever you made alpha form, it is interconvertible to beta form, and alpha form to beta form, alpha form to beta form, like this interconvertible. So before alpha form converting into open chain form, then converting into beta form. See, suppose you made alpha form. Alpha form converting into open chain form. Open chain further converting into beta form. So beta form, suppose you made beta form converting into open chain form, again you'll convert converting into alpha form. These three forms are interconvertible. Whatever you made the form, that is finally come to the open chain form. Its open chain form rotation is plus 52.5 degrees. That's why it is coming to the open chain form. Is it clear? Now I am showing the net optical rotation calculation also. After that, once again, I'll come back to the explanation. See, net optical activity. Net optical activity. We have two forms. Equal to 36% alpha. It's 110 degrees. Plus 64% of beta. It is how much? Plus 19.7 degrees. Plus 19.7 degrees. So we are going to calculate this one. By 2. This is into. So by 2. If you calculate here, you will get plus 52.5 degrees. Plus 52.5 degrees. Finally, what I am trying to say here, if you make any form, alpha form or beta form, definitely it converting after certain time, it converting into open chain form. What is open chain form? Free aldehyde group. It can show rotation plus 52.5 degrees. Okay. This interconversion, alpha form to beta form, or else alpha form converting into open chain further converting into beta, beta to open chain to alpha form. This interconversion only we call it as muta rotation. So many times we are getting in questions also, competitive exams, sucrose, it will show muta rotation or not. Sucrose will not show muta rotation. Lactose and maltose shows muta rotation. Lactose and maltose having hesitol ring, hemiacetal ring. Due to that reason, it shows muta rotation and it is reducing sugars. I will show once I will explain the disaccharide. Hope everybody clear this one. Next one, inverted sugar. Inverted sugar. Sugar, sucrose is called it as, next important one is sugar. Sugar is also called inverted sugar. Why we call inverted sugar? Sucrose is nothing but sugar, right? This is also called as cane sugar, inverted sugar. Why we call inverted sugar? I will show now. Sucrose generally it is dextrorotatory, plus 66.5 degrees angle. Okay, dextrorotatory. So on hydrolysis, we are getting glucose and fructose. Okay, so this glucose is dextrorotatory, plus 52.5 degrees. Just now we have seen it shows plus 52.5. So here dextrorotatory, this is what dextro. And fructose is minus 92.4 degrees. This is levorotatory. So which is the dominating one rotation? Fructose. Fructose dominating. So the net optical rotation it shows negative. That's the reason sucrose we call it as inverted cane sugar. Inverted cane sugar. See, net optical, I am writing here, net optical behavior. Starting we have taken it is dextrorotatory. But once it forms the glucose and fructose, final end it showing negative. Negative is nothing but levorotatory. Why? Net optical behavior you can see plus 52.5 plus minus 92.4 by 2 forms. Okay, finally you will get minus 19.85 degrees. See, starting it is plus. That's the reason dextrorotatory. Plane polarized light moves towards right hand side, that we call it as dextrorotatory, and the plane polarized light moves left hand side, that we call it as levorotatory, right? So first it is showing dextrorotatory, but once it forms glucose and fructose, finally it's showing levorotatory. So negative, that is why we call it as it is inverted sugar. So why it is showing negative? Because fructose is dominating here. If you see net optical behavior, it is showing negative, that is levo, inverted cane sugar. Clear, students? That's it. Now, starch and cellulose also, some important points I am giving in this video. And the next video, upcoming videos, I am going to do disaccharides and amino acids, important points which is frequently asking in competitive examination. And the last, DNA, RNA, main important points I will discuss with you. Now, in this video, what I am discussing, polysaccharides. Next point is polysaccharides. Polysaccharides is, already we have discussed definitions. Polysaccharides means many. If you hydrolysis polysaccharides, it gives many monosaccharides. Okay. Polysaccharides of first, I will discuss, we have two polysaccharides. One is starch, another one is cellulose. Unit linkage is important. I will write like a note points all starch. Starch, polysaccharide of starch is polysaccharide of only alpha glucose. Next important point. It has two units. It contains two components. One is amylose. This is alpha alpha 1 4 linkage. Same like maltose. Okay, alpha alpha 1 4 linkage. And next, with 200 to 1000 glucose units. Okay, so if you draw the structure, this is like maltose. Like this it will go. So 1-4 linkage. I will show once I had explained disaccharides, you'll get more idea. So, and next important point under this, water soluble. Next, whenever you have a starch powder at home, you can do this experiment. If you add in water, only some percentage, 15 to 20% only it is soluble. 15 to 20% only this amylose units are there. This is water soluble. Now, next one, students. 15 to 20% only amylose. Next important point is unbranched. This is unbranched. Next, starch, another one. What is the next unit here? This is amylose, 0.1, two components. Next component is your amylopectin. Amylopectin is branched with 1-6 linkage. See, same above unit you can take it. this is amylose, right? And this amylopectin, this is one, this is one, and the sixth one, it linked. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, then this is here 5, here 6, here connection. Again, this is normal. Two amylose units connected by 1,6 linkage. That's it. So like this. Okay. This is amylopectin. And here, this amylopectin, like this, 80 to 85% it is. How much? Above cases, 15 to 20%. Now this is 80 to 85%. And the two water insoluble. That is the reason if you add water in starch, only less amount is, less content is soluble. Major is not soluble. Okay. Non-reducing sugar. You can write here points. Final important point. Starch. Starch is non-reducing sugar. Non-reducing sugar. No mutarotation. Due to lack of hemiacetal. That's it. Now, next one. In today's video, last topic, that is what? Cellulose also main important points we will discuss. Next, fourth one, cellulose. First one, what I have taught for you, mutarotation. Second one, inverted cane sugar. Third one, starch, polysaccharide starch. Now, cellulose. Polysaccharide of only beta glucose unit. Beta glucose. Here most of the students confusing galactose. No, it is glucose. Beta glucose unit. And linkages. Beta glucose, 1,4 linkage. 1,4 linkage. That's it. This is N linkage, N type linkage. Disaccharide lactose time you will come to know. Like this linkage, beta 1,4 linkage. Beta 1,4 linkage. That's it. Okay, this is about cellulose. Starch only glucose unit. In cellulose only, beta glucose, starch only alpha glucose. So both are plays very important role for competitive examination. Just linkages they are asking. Okay, students, next upcoming videos, I am going to do disaccharides and amino acids and DNA, RNA also. So please give likes and subscribe our channel. If possible to share, please share to all your friends. Everybody will get benefit. And more useful videos, total chapter almost I'm explaining. Okay, students, thank you. Thanks for watching.